Hey, bro.
Stay on the line.
You see them 11 assists, right? You see he throwing out 11 knives, right?
See what I said, post game. I said, I got to worry about getting one on the car right here. How are you feeling when you grabbed that last rebound and solidified
the victory? Yeah, it felt good, man. You know, we want to protect home court, you know, so that was big for us to come out and secure that one. You know, I don't know if I showed that much emotion, you know, through the playoffs that much, but, you know, not having Chris out there and it, you know, being a high intense game, you know, we wanted that one bad. So, you know, it's obviously only one. We know what they're capable of and what they've done. Came back down 0-2 from, you know, their past two series. So, you know, we got to stay locked in.
Did you know you were well on your way to a triple-double?
No, man. I mean, I think I've came close a few times in my career and just never got over the hump, but, you know, I'll take it now.
Next up is David Brandt with the Associated Press, followed by Chris Haynes.
Hey, Devin.
What's up?
I'm in here, too.
My man.
Good to see you, man. Paul George and you were trading some pretty elite shots in that third quarter. He got going, and then you kind of had to respond. Did you feel it was kind of an important, you know, they were – threatening to run away a little bit, and then you scored, you know, a bunch of those mid-range jumpers. Just kind of take me through that stretch.
Yeah, just, you know, trying to assert my aggressiveness in there. Without Chris, you know, taking on the playmaking role, you know, of trying to find the balance of keeping everybody involved and imposing my will on the game. And, you know, I think they got up 6-8. I know what stretch you're talking about. And, you know, I just want to be aggressive. So, you know, we did a lot of high ball screens and just get to my spot and –